It's perfect ski weather. You are swooshing down the side of a mountain on soft powder when there's a rumbling behind you. You look back to see a giant wall of snow racing toward you. Oh no, it's an avalanche. Is there any way you can avoid it? How could you survive? This is your body on surviving an avalanche. The snowslide is gaining on you. You're not gonna make it. Suddenly, everything goes dark. You're buried under snow. Avalanches claim 150 lives every year. But even though they are extremely dangerous, there are ways to survive. How are you going to get out from under all this snow? And how long do you have before you run out of air? Avalanche. There's little to no chance you'll be able to get out of the way of an avalanche. It can reach a speed of 320 kilometers per hour. It will be on you in seconds. If you can, grab a tree and hold on tight. If you have anything heavy, discard it. If you're on a snowmobile, get off. You want to be as light as possible to try and ride the wave. Once the avalanche reaches you, keep your mouth closed and your teeth clenched. Try to stay on top of the snow. If you can't, keep swimming upward. 1 minute. You've stopped moving. You try to gather your senses, but you don't even know which way is up. Try to move your arms and clear some space around your mouth. You need to create some air pockets. Spit into the snow and see which way the spittle runs. This will tell you which way is down. Push your arm upward and see if you can break the surface. If you can, great. You should be able to dig yourself out. If you're not near the surface, don't use too much effort trying to get out. Too much movement can make you sink further. Stay calm. Panicking and screaming will use the air you have. Even though snow is porous, you only have about 18 minutes of oxygen. 10 minutes. Okay, hypothermia is setting in. You're confused, exhausted, and shivering. Your breathing is shallow and rapid as you use up the oxygen. Your skin will start turning blue.
Oh, that's very nice.
In 2020, a skier was caught in two successive avalanches in Idaho. The first avalanche trapped him just beneath the surface. The second one buried him under 2.7 meters of snow. He was unable to move and had trouble breathing. He was found by a rescue team 1 hour later. Thankfully, he had enough air to survive. Sadly, three others didn't. Many skiers wear avalanche beacons, which transmit their location if a rescue is required. Another option is an avalanche airbag. This can keep you on top of the snow and work as a marker for rescuers. 15 minutes. The hypothermia is severe now, and there's a danger your heart could stop beating. Wait, light breaks through the snow. You've been found, but you'll need immediate medical treatment if there's any hope of survival. You'll need to stay in the hospital, overnight at the very least. If you have any broken bones, you may need a cast. And you might need an organ transplant due to the severe hypothermia or oxygen starvation. Your recovery may take time. If you were oxygen deprived for too long, you might have permanent brain damage. This could cause changes to your personality and quality of life. You also may have post-traumatic stress disorder, commonly referred to as PTSD. Okay, now that you've survived an avalanche, let's find out what it would be like if you were buried in a grave, still alive. We'll dig into that one on another episode of Your Body On.